Hi and welcome to the first session of the Building Programming Language with LLVM. My name is Dmitry Soshnikov and I'll be teaching this class. And just to set the agenda, this is a very practical class. Right, the same as other classes in the Building from Scratch series, here most of the videos will be actual practical exercises. And the first thing we need to say, this class has set of prerequisites. First of all, we'll need basic C++ experience, but at the same time, this is not a class about C++. So instead of very specific C++ constructs, we'll be using very basic constructs, like for example simple loops instead of algorithm functions. The same goes to the very specific LLVM wrappers. For example, analyzing LLVM code, you will see a lot of string ref, array ref wrappers. We'll be omitting those for brevity, but this is something you can use for better performance. Again, our goal is to show very concise and to the point implementation, right? Omitting very specific details. Now, we will not be using any build system as well, like CMake or Make. We'll be using plain header files with a single C++ file. Again, this is not class about C++, so feel free to set up any build system you need. We'll be just using the single command, right? Using Clang utility to compile, and this is how we're able to execute our programs, passing either the expression or the file. But of course, we will need certain LLVM core libraries, so we'll be using that LLVM config tool, which will allow us including headers from LLVM. Now, in addition to the C++ basic knowledge, it is highly recommended to take two courses, Essentials of Interpretation, known as Building an Interpreter from Scratch, and also Building a Virtual Machine. Now, unless you're familiar with how to build a programming language at the high level, that is at the AST level, unless you know concept of environment, scope chain resolution, how eval works, etc., it is highly recommended to take this course. Also, LLVM is about a lower level implementation of programming languages, so it's also recommended to take Building a Virtual Machine, where we built a lower level VM with a custom bytecode. Also, we need to say that this specific class on LLVM, in contrast, for example, with other classes, has very basic evergreen concepts and also rapidly dynamically changing. For example, if we take a class on the garbage collectors, most of the concepts were invented in 1950s, right, and still the same, like Mark Sweep garbage collector you can reuse today. Not the case with LLVM. The implementation for this infrastructure is rapidly changing, and for example, until version 14, we had so-called raw pointers, right? You have specific type, and you have to explicitly cast one pointer type to other pointer type. Since version 15, LLVM switched to so-called opaque pointers. You can just use PTR instruction, and you can also omit explicit casting. So the main takeaway, it's literally impossible to design a sustainable knowledge class if we focus only on dynamically changing details, such as different APIs, format of the IR, etc. And this is not the goal of this class. Instead, we'll focus on the very generic evergreen concepts, which will stay the same regardless of the LLVM version, such as generic concept of compilation, design patterns of virtual machines, and the core ecosystem of LLVM. So in this specific class, we use LLVM version 14, but again, it's not the point. For the rapidly changing parts, you have to track and migrate if you would like to newer format, but the main concept will stay the same, and we will be focusing exactly on those. And despite having VM in its name, LLVM is actually not a virtual machine, but rather the compiler infrastructure. Let's see what it is. So in previous classes, we say that we distinguish languages on interpreted and compiled. And in fact, it's rather not the languages, but implementations, right? You might have interpreted version of the same language and compiled version of the same language. And LLVM infrastructure supports actually all of them. It has inline interpreter, it has ahead of time compiler and JIT compiler. And in this class, we will focus on ahead of time compiler and we'll slightly talk about how we can use JIT as well. So let's recall the generic ahead of time compiler. All right, so here's again our simple program, print hello. And the first module which meets our program is the tokenizer, which groups individual characters into recognizable stream of tokens, which is then is passed to the next module, which is called parser, right? Which ensures that those tokens go in specific order. And as the result of the parser, we get so-called AST, that is abstract syntax tree. That is the first intermediate representation which we can pass either to interpreter or compiler. In the classic compiler, we pass the AST to a module which is called code generator, right, which can produce multiple intermediate representations, that is IRs, which are eventually translated to the native code, right, for specific target architecture, which is then passed to CPU, and we get the result at runtime. Again, so this is the ahead of time compilation. That is, we translate the full source code to the target code before execution. And that's exactly what we'll be focusing on in this class in terms of LLVM. Now, in compiler design, we also have front-end and back-end, and LLVM is exactly the infrastructure which allows us reusing existing and well-tested back-end, which is capable of generating multiple target architectures. So let's see what it is. Now, here's the same. We pass the AST to the module, which is called LLVM IR generator, which produces the intermediate representation known as LLVM IR, right? Not arbitrary bytecode or bitcode, but the specified bitcode, which is further passed to the black box called LLVM, right, which is the backend, which is capable to produce multiple architectures, which again we pass down to the CPU and get the result. So this is the high-level picture of this course. Now, in terms of backend and frontend, LLVM considers code generation from AST down to IR is also a frontend, and this is exactly our focus, right? We'll get the AST and produce the IR. We'll be skipping the parsing stage altogether, right? Using just S expression format, as in other classes. However, if you're interested how to translate source code down to AST, you might also take parser classes. One of them is called Building a Parser from Scratch, right? Very practical and manual parser, recursive descent. Or you may even take the Essentials of Parsing, where we build automated parser and talk about parsing algorithms such as LL, LR, etc. So with this being said, please meet Eva, or meet again, for those who have taken previous classes. As we said, we'll be using S expression format, that is the parenthesized expression, where the first element, that is the type tag, defines the expression type. In this case, we see the addition expression, type tag plus, so the result here is 15. We see the assignment expression, type tag set, and also we see complex expressions. For example, if expression has three nested sub-expressions. Here's the another example, function declaration. As you can see, we use the def keyword from the Python. And we also need to say that LLVM is actually type language, right? This is how the type version of the parameters and return value looks like. We have the pair, parameter name and its type, and also may specify the return type. And here we use types not for specific type checking semantics, but rather to understand which operation to apply, right? For example, integer versus float, and also to understand how much memory to allocate. However, if you're interested in the type checking semantics, you may take the class, which is called Building a Type Checker from Scratch, where we talk about type theory, type semantics, and build a static type checker. We will start talking about LLVM specific constructs such as module, context in the next lectures. And already today, let's start jumping into the actual practice, to the implementation. Okay, so I'm creating the directory for our project, Eva LLVM. Today, we'll just slightly touch the concept of LLVM IR, not go into compilation yet, which we'll start in the next lecture. Again, in this course, we use LLVM 14. Again, we don't focus on the rapidly changing and specific constructs, rather on generic concepts of compilation, right, and using LLVM infrastructure ecosystem. So the Clang is built on top of LLVM itself. As you can see, I have the version 14 for Apple. To install LLVM, I use the port, Mac ports, passing the LLVM 14 module name. And then I can use the select command to set the list of installation and to set the active installation. Right, again, we use the set command and it's successfully activated. Now, once installed, we'll have a lot of LLVM tools, main of which is called LLC. That is LLVM Compiler, which is also, as we can see, version 14, and it supports multiple targets. The one we're interested in is the x86-64, but for example, it supports also WebAssembly, so it's possible to take this code and compile it to be runnable on the web. And before going to compilation, let's actually start from the very simple test file from C++ file, which returned the simple number, 42. Now, as the Clang is built on top of LLVM itself, we can use the flag called emit LLVM, passing the S option for the source, which produces the file called test LL, that is LLVM IR. Let's take a look, and here exactly it is. So we can see our value 42 is returned from the main function, but there's a lot of metadata here. The main thing is Clang is able to take this LL file and produce the binary code, which we can execute and get the result. Now, in addition to LLC, which is the ahead of time compiler, and the Clang, there is also a tool called LLI, that is LLVM Interpreter. And instead of generating the native code, we can just use Interpreter, pass in the test LL directly, and get the same result. So let's take a look at the structure of the LLVM IR. As you can see at top, we have different meta information, one of which is called data layout. And this data layout string is the representation of the memory layout, so it describes alignment and the size of data structures, as well as endian, little endian, big endian, the size of the pointer, etc. And during this course, I recommend using the language reference, located at this address, where you can read about specific data layout string. Now, this is not very essential for this class. Moreover, all this information can be automatically inferred. As we'll see shortly, we can just directly remove it. And actually, let's start doing that. Let's clean up all the metadata. For now, we don't need those instructions, allocate and storage. We'll get to them later. Just returning 42. Okay, clean up this one and clean up everything else. So this is the minimum LLVM IR program. As you can see, we have only the main function. We use define keyword to define functions. One thing to notice, we use ampersand symbol to define global symbols. And all the functions in LLVM are actually global. There's no concept of local functions, but we will see how we implement closures, etc. And we just return the value 42, specifying the return type. Okay, we can pass this program down to LLI and get correct result. Let's check it again. And it works. So you can use this tool just to play with LLVM IR itself and understand the programs. Let's show again we can use Clang to compile the same file. Now we get some warning since Clang uses specific checks. So let's actually return the metadata for the target machine architecture. And again, it just works. In this case, again, we compiled down to native code and then executed the native file. Now, in addition to that, there's a tool which is called LLVM Assembler. In fact, this LLVM IR is a readable representation of the bit code, which is used by the LLVM virtual machine and the compiler. So the assembler produces the BC file, which stands for bit code, right? In contrast with Java, which make popular term bytecode, here we use bit code. And this bit code is nothing but the binary representation of the same IR. And there's inverse tool called LLVM Disassembler. Let's pass the output file name as test2. And as you can see, it's exactly the same files, right? Just generated from different modules. Again, going back to the function, the main function is required. So this is the main entry point. Again, as you can see, it has return type, ampersand specifying that this is global symbol. And so we have return statement with also specified type. Another point, we can pass this LLVM file down to Clang, specifying the S option, which will generate the native assembly code, native assembly. Right, so this is test.s, and here we also see the value 42. Exactly the same, we pass down to Clang, generate binary code, and execute. Okay, so that's it for today. That's the introductory lecture and what we'll be building. In the next lecture, we'll start talking about actual LLVM program structure. Right, we'll talk about what is module, context, IR builder, and we'll start building the compiler. That's it for today. Thanks and see you in the class.